welcome to my lecture. We'll now move on from the early medieval period, the Viking Age, to the high medieval era and the next phase of urbanization. Jasmine is the predecessor and the follower of Viking Age Hedeville and the Borean Like, as Justin mentioned, Twisso. What I'm going to present you is pretty much main regards from my PhD work finished in 2015. I'm going to start with a brief introduction on Schleswig. And it's the most important thing about Schleswig to know is its favorable topographic location. Schleswig is best located in Schleswig-Holstein, south of Denmark, at the narrowest part of the so-called Kimbrian or Jutlandic Peninsula. And this topographic position, in this narrowest part, this position in between several economic zones, the economic zone of the North Sea, the Baltic Sea, with the hinterlands, as well as combines, connects also the continent and Scandinavia. This is really important for the medieval trade connections. This becomes also clear when we slide into Schleswig-Holstein, and we have really good access to Schleswig as well as from the Baltic as from the North Sea by ship. It's just a land bridge of 15 to 20 kilometers in between, so you have really good access for the main transportation vessel in medieval times. So Schleswig itself is situated in the inner end of the Schleifdort. Today's city extent is can be seen on this map. What also can recognize is here, this is the famous semicircular rampart of Hedeby, and just 2 kilometers up north there is Schleswig located. And this is in the former peninsula, as I was showing you now. On the digital erasure model, this is the former peninsula of Schleswig, where the old town was founded in the mid, around the mid 11th century. And the blue lines are the historical shoreline. And this is important to know when we come to the next, when I'm going to present to you the features, the ecological features, and how they are to be understood. That's one of the main things. This peninsula is approximately 12 hectares in size, with an additional peninsula on the right hand side. Some hard facts about Schleswig in the High Middle Ages. As I mentioned already, the success of Viking Age Hedeby. It has been a bishop's see with cathedral and at least 7 churches. It was a place of power. There was a palatinate of the Danish king and the see of the Duke of Schleswig located in Schleswig itself. But the most important thing about Schleswig is its economic power. It was one of the major hubs of the North European long-distance trade. And it's not about a large hinterland for Schleswig, it's just about this special topographic position that all the trade connections coming from Novgorod and the east and going up to southern France all moved via Schleswig. And this is the important thing to know. It's not more like that the goods are like stored there and maybe very important for the Iron Society of the Danish kingdom. It's more like this, this managing of those different trade routes that come together in Schleswig. Schleswig has been subjected to a couple of excavations starting off in the 1950s, and there was a large old town restoration campaign in the 70s, opening a lot of soil. And most of these red parts in the former old town are resulting from this era. And one of the large excavations are the Dessenstraße and the Hafenstraße, and they, as you can see, they are in between the former shoreline of the 11th century, so they revealed a good basis for the former harbor and shore development. And what also is to say that we have a rise of water level in the 11th century, so the earliest structures in this era, area, have been well preserved. So we have mainly the structures from the 11th and early 12th century are completely revealed. So we are talking about thousands of preserved modern features. And yes, how to deal with such a good basis that has been excavated in the 70s. what X-Rayder did back then was a method, set up for Helleby, was to draw the duck down in artificial layers and of 15 centimeters and draw every 15 centimeters. What turned out were 350 large scale drawings of 1.50 meters in size and 1.50 meters in height. And they had scale 1 to 20. And you have an example above how they looked like. This is like a small, that's a small scene from one of those large scale drawings. And you have marked all information on them, like the soil information, the information to the activities, etc. And what I and a colleague did was to put everything of those drawings, scan them, and digitalize them in GIS. Then we was a new examination of dendro samples. I had at least 500 dendrochronological dates on approximately 9,000 identified wooden features. What turned out was this GIS project with the 9,000 fingers connected, of course, with an Access database. And you could also build with the ArcSee application, make a 3D model out of it. So this was my basis for interpretation. And yeah, now I'm going to present to you the major results of this of my interpretations. This is the situation of Schleswig around 1100. This 3D model results out of the ArcSee data, so it's at least the central part of this picture fits one to one the original data. And of course, the epicenter that goes upward is like kind of interpretation and reconstruction, but at least the positions of the houses and everything else is on the correct place. What you see here is a marketplace, a harbor market. In the central area, and we have a lot of dam structures on both sides with houses and workshops and other facilities on it, and we have a street system running from the shore into the city center. Everything started out in Schleswig in the 1070s. The Super Schild excavation 1071 is the earliest dendro date from Schleswig known to date. But as early as in the 1075, we have the first development of the shore in Schleswig. And what happened then was to a layout of our rectangular plots set in right angle to the shore. And they have been connected with a shore parallel street. And also the streets running from the shore to the city center. This is the plots mainly can be seen in the upper part of the picture. The next step was the developing of the waterfront, and this is the most interesting thing happening in Schleswig, because as early in the late 1080s, the whole peninsula was just, as I mentioned, perfect of size, was fully developed, so there was a lack of space. And what happened is that the people who owned or rented those plots moved into the shallow water. And they built some bulkheads from the spitwood planks filled with brushwood, dung, and soil. So they have massive platforms just in front of their parcels. The plots. And it started out in 1087, and then the neighbors had one in 1088, and then proceeded on the whole southern shore of the Otown Peninsula, Schleswig. And it doesn't stay at this point, so people started to move on. So after a couple of years, they set the next part in front of the old dam construction, so they protruded further into the deeper water of the Schlei Fjord. So by 1100, this resulted in the picture I just showed you. And as those dam structures followed exactly the plots who were living in private facilities, those dam structures are also like, they differ, they look the same, but they differ in detail. They use different kinds of wood, for example, or different kind of size and have different development on it. And what followed of the stems was a couple of, just 1 to 2 years later, they built houses on it, they built workshops, they had also empty space on it, and pig pens, home, and on those plots, on those dams, there were professional merchants who housed there, professional traders in this area, and just a type of not a fixed route there. Many people from many types of the high-end society in Scandinavia were involved in the trade, and emerging from same professional trade, this is an important step that can be depicted here, because there were also monks involved, as slaves were involved in the trade back then, the king itself and noblemen, landowners. So we don't have the not yet the class of a trader, but different kinds of people of society were involved in this trade back then. And what can be seen here in Schleswig is that we have a kind of competition in the favorable position in the waterfront, because all the ships with the goods and the foreign traders emerged to Schleswig. The cards come from Honningstedt, the North Sea harbor of Schleswig, to this place. And when having been drowned in this kind of pool position in the harbor, they attract those foreign merchants. So they were housed on those dam structures in the houses, because it was common in medieval Scandinavia to house foreign merchants for a couple of days. And so the most profited from each other. There was a win-win situation by having this plot and this infrastructure on the itself, but the guests could use this infrastructure too. The trade itself but took place on a public ground. And this is the exception. This is a plot of dam structure which is twice as big as the private owned facilities. It is a plot without any built up structures, with one exception. This is a special kind of house with some special. It has been specially constructed in another way, like the normal houses. But the rest is a clear place, empty place. And we also have like the largest amount of the spherical zone weights. We already actually know from Tilsu earlier on. And this is the highest amount of those zone weights ever found, which has been found in this area of the marketplace. So the marketplace was important in the times for creating public for transactions, because you don't, when you're foreign and in this city like Schleswig, in a town like Schleswig, there's the problem that when you're tricked or fooled with a living transaction, you have to prove it, that you have been proved, and that you can call eyewitnesses in front of court. And when the transaction takes place in public, you can name people who might have witnessed this transaction or this fooling. And on the other hand, the king who controls the city in Schleswig had the interest in having public transactions, because he was the tax this transactions probably. The tax, of course, the ships who are coming to Schleswig and the cars coming to Schleswig, but probably could also tax the transaction itself. To sum up, the Schleswig waterfront is a rapidly developing town, the Schleswig waterfront rapidly develops within just 3 decades from the empty shore up to this fully developed waterfront with dam structures, street infrastructure, and landing facilities for ships. We have similar shore installations in Trondheim in the 11th century. We know them from London, but in no other place there's such a rapid development like in Schleswig. And I would like to close with the contextualization of those just presented. The 11th century in Northern Europe can be described as some catchphrases like urbanization, Christianization. We have the rise of Scandinavian kingdoms and the set of territorial states. We have a professionalization of merchant seafaring connected with larger and more effective transport vessels with a higher amount of bulk cargo trade, and so on. And of course, we have a waterfront development. And this is where Schleswig is in between. And this is the missing link for what we know already. We started off in the early Middle Ages, Viking Age, with beach markets on the seasonal occasions, simple landing places. And they developed until the late Viking Age to complex harbor markets, as we know from Hedeby, for example, and with landing facilities like jetties. And from the late Middle Ages, we know we have a subdivision of the trade function. We have like central marketplaces inside cities like known from pretty much all Hanseatic towns in the Baltic Sea. There's the central marketplaces where the local people get their stuff, but the professional trade and the large bulk cargo trade took place inside the houses of on private properties of the professional merchants. And I have brought to you and I presented this picture of the famous Eden House in the Hanseatic cities, which is like a symbol of the power of the independence of the Hanseatic merchant, and this large storage facilities inside the building. And the waterfront was just remained just for loading and unloading ships and doing ship services, but not for this large trade actions anymore. And what I just showed you, Schleswig in the 11th century, is more or less the missing link in this development. Schleswig itself still has this harbor market situation where transactions take place directly at the waterfront, but we already have these private facilities of the emerging professional merchants, that a class that's just developing and just a class that is just emerging from the semi-professional status to him to his high professional merchant, independent merchant that we know from the late Middle Ages. So I want to close and thank you for your attention.